Hello, can you hear me?
Yep, go ahead, Steven.
Okay, actually, I just wanted to verify my microphone was working. So
recording in progress.
I'm just that's all I have to say about it. I'll have other comments later. Thanks.
Okay, thank you. On to let's call for a motion.
As was mentioned before, our esteemed president passed several milestones this year, and we all really need to congratulate him. He's made an impressive number and looks great, and he's had success in his personal life, and his kids are on their way. And this is an important moment, and I do think it's just something to congratulate him for. As we're all heading down the path of becoming, older and wiser, and we all have a legacy that we bring forward. And unfortunately, due to the infirmities of age, we're all going to find ourselves in a situation where mobility is a little bit more challenging. The activities that we once enjoyed are not going to be there anymore. We're going to be slowing down. And this is a great opportunity. I would love to see, I've asked for this before, and it doesn't seem to ever get on the agenda, but think of ways that we can improve the accessibility of Marinwood Park, and make our programs more friendly to the senior population. Easy things. I'll talk. I was camping in this last month and up on the coast, and I was walking on accessible trail. And there are actually some standards that are used on accessible trails. It's very easy for us to make Marinwood Park completely accessible, and I think that would be an important goal. Also, to provide more seating for seniors and accessible bathrooms, which are much needed, not only by, they're needed by everybody. For the amount that we use the park, we need more stalls available, and we can put in a prefab unit next to the tennis courts at a pretty low price. The last I checked, it was about $50,000 for a prefab unit that gets dropped in off a trailer, and it's the same kind of thing that's used in the county park system. So, congratulations, Bill, and congratulations, everybody else. Let's make this a great night and think about ways that we can improve as a community.
Thank you, Steven. Anybody else here?
No.
Yes. Yes, thank you. I was surprised that we didn't have full approval. I thought that's what we had prior to contracting with our contractor. I assume that we've already contracted for money. We've also, we're in it, but we're not starting it, and this must be costing us money. And I'm a little concerned about change orders already, and we haven't even started the process. Can you provide any more information other than it's being delayed? Is there a problem with, say, setbacks or drainage or other issues that may require the revisit of the plan? I know, because I walk that area daily, there's a lot of concern about that area being so massive. I know it's just during the construction phase, but also there's a impact to the horseshoe pit. I know from comments a lot of people make, they don't like walking past that area, especially on a Friday night when everyone's drinking heavily, and horseshoes are flying. I hope we can work a better solution where we can actually gain access to that space. I'm asking you just to basically take a look at that. I appreciate the fact that larger signs have gone up as far as people walking their bikes. It really hasn't been an issue as far as I could tell. But anyhow, I'm looking forward to getting this construction moving along. And, hopefully at the end of this, we're going to have a good project and that we can all at least feel some good about. So thanks.
Thank you, Stephen. Okay.
Yes, hi, Chief White. I mentioned I was camping up in the North Coast, and California State Parks were doing thinning like you're describing. They were using mechanized means to clear the undergrowth, and I'm just wondering if there are any areas either in San Rafael, anywhere actually in our neighborhood, where where you've completed this undergrowth work. I think it would certainly put my mind at ease. I do support the project, but I just want to make sure that it's being done in a environmentally responsible manner. I know it's going to have impact, but do you know of any area right now that you could point to or say, hey, they did it right here and this is what we're going to do? Okay, so hopefully they're going to give me a little extra time there. I don't mean to speak over you, but I notice the clock is ticking here. I was just wondering if there's an area that you can say, hey, we did it right, and go look at that area. Thing, and this is from news reports, there was an accident that happened on Lucas Valley Road. I think a 63-year-old person on a motorcycle was struck by a deer right near, just right up the road, right up near the county farm there. And I notice it's not in your report. Do you know anything about that? This was a couple weeks ago. I read it in the patch as a kind of a news flash. It did say crews responded. It didn't say which agency. And obviously it was a terrible thing that happened. It sounded like there was a deer just ran out and just broadsided this guy on a motor scooter, probably traveling at 50 miles an hour. He had a heart attack and didn't make it to the hospital. But okay, good. Look forward to seeing more good work. Thanks.
Thank you. Stephen?
Yes, thanks, Luke. So I'll just start with pool. So you are going back to drop-in for lap swimming, which is great. Very disappointed that you can't figure out something for membership. It doesn't seem terribly complicated to me. You just figure out what portion of the summer's left and prorate it. The punch pass system for a heavy pool user like I have been in the past is much, much more expensive, and I'm concerned that you're not looking at ways to normalize the pool program. Of course, we pay taxes for everyone's salaries and for that pool and everything else, and so we do expect that, you know, we're not going to be charged retail rates necessarily to access what is basically our pool. So could the staff or I guess the board direct the staff to find some solution for a partial year membership? It's not complicated. We can probably do it in about 15 minutes. As far as the mini park goes, I sent a couple letters to Luke and Eric, and I did not receive a courtesy reply. I had concerns that the play structure was not open, and then next thing I know, it was open, which was great. I did look at the deck, and I inspected underneath, and it does look very lightly built, and suggested that additional supports be placed under those plastic boards. I don't think it's robust enough for real heavy use, and it's going to break again. So mark my words, it's going to break again if you don't fix it. The good news is I think that both of our play structures look pretty good to me. We do need to make them accessible. We have an affirmative need to provide accessible swings. It's part of the law. We need to follow the law and provide accessible paths to make this available to mobility impaired children. So I would hope that you would move that up in your priority list. Lastly, I'd like to say, you know, this playground project, the more I think about it, the more I'm looking at what the options were, which was basically almost exact replacement of what we have there. It doesn't make sense to me to replace those units. What it does make sense to me is that we have additional recreational facilities, and I suggested that we convert the tot pool to a splash pad, which is very popular with kids, and will encourage more use of our pool area. We could probably do it for the same amount of money than, I'm guessing, a simple splash pad we probably could do for a couple hundred thousand dollars, and it would just, there would be a net gain. And the other thing I was thinking is if we had a pool slide built in into the berms, and maybe some additional swings and climbing structures throughout the park, you know, we can make the park nicer, you know. So let's not waste our money and just, you know, replacing something that really can be fixed and doesn't need fully to be replaced. So that, and you know, accessibility is so important. I do want to say that there was a small gathering of neighbors on the 4th of July. They wanted to get out. We were in the firemen's picnic area. And actually, I was out last Saturday, and every picnic table was filled. People were making music. They were enjoying themselves. And, you know, it's just a good reminder of how wonderful our park is, and how well used it is and treasured by the community. So thank you very much. Let's maintain it well and yes. You know, my themes, actually, what I've been talking about for a while is accessibility and legacy. I would really, really like you to consider how this park of ours can be made more beautiful, more accessible, more meaningful for our wider community. It's not, our parks are not just about summer camps. They're not just about, you know, having kids play soccer and some people play tennis and dog walkers. It's much more than that. This is a place of life. This is a place of community. This is a place of art. Hopefully it won't be a place of alcohol, but I ask that you consider in your next meeting about accessibility, and also I would I think the drinking in the park has actually kind of exceeded reasonableness, and I also would ask that you look at policies you can do to reduce the alcohol abuse that occurs on a regular basis in our park.
Thank you, Stephen.
Yes, are you, do you hear me? Can you hear
me? Go ahead.
Okay. So, I do believe that the board may be abusing the closed session provisions. You do have to report out what actually you're doing. You can't just meet in closed session to keep your secrets hidden. The public has a right to know, and you have a responsibility to report the good and the bad that's happening within our district. Obviously, we didn't get information on the delays prior to the board voting on a multi-million dollar project. You know, what do we know? We don't know anything. We live in a democracy, and what that means is you have an affirmative responsibility to report out to the community and to communicate with the community and solicit their input as well. So, you know, I can't comment on what I don't know, and I guess maybe you like it that way, but that is completely wrong. Thank you.
Thank you. And I guess with that, we'll go into closed session at 8:29.
Yeah, and hold on a second. Good. Thank you, guys. And then we will go into closed session. Thank you very much for that.